So today I want to take you through a product sourcing tutorial. Now, this is for bulk arbitrage specifically, and it's going to be a complete game changer that's going to save you time, help you make more money quicker, obviously, and take a lot of the guesswork and kind of, you know, legwork out of it for you, so you don't have to run back from sites to Amazon, from sites to Amazon, and check product to product, okay? So there are many sourcing softwares out there. There are many ways to source products on bulk deal sites or just retail sites in general. And a lot of those softwares are like built-in integrated softwares where you put all the information into the software and then it's gonna spit you out data which you can then go look for, okay? But there is one software that we're gonna go over today. It's called OhAGenius, and I'm gonna talk about it here in a second. And what it does is it allows you to actually go to the sites and instead of manually sourcing and spending time on the sites, literally saying, oh, this looks like a good product, let me check it out on Amazon, taking the information, searching it on Amazon or searching the ASIN, right? Finding the corresponding product for that actual product and then checking to, you know, down the checklist. Can I sell it? Is it a good product opportunity? How's the listing? What's the competition? Is it profitable, right? Instead of doing all those things individually for every single product, this is gonna save you a boatload of time because you can do this on any of the integrated sites. And I think there's like 20 to 50. You can actually check that on oagenius.com, which we'll talk about here in a second. And then basically what you do is you just use the extension and it's gonna spit you out all the data for all the products on that page and their corresponding Amazon listings so that you don't have to actually look through and check every single one individually. Instead, you're gonna be able to see in the columns, okay, this is the price on Amazon, this is the buy price, right? And this is the corresponding product, okay? So it's really gonna save you a lot of time and put all the data streamlined for you so you don't waste time searching for products that clearly aren't profitable, right? Because in online arbitrage, the name of the game is sourcing profitable products, but saving time so you can source more profitable products in whatever time window you have, right? Maybe you're doing it full time and you're doing it like 5 hours a day or 8 hours a day, right? Nobody sources 8 hours a day, I don't care what they say. But you know, maybe you have a lot of time, or maybe you're just doing it on the side and you only have like 20 minutes to like an hour a day to source. This is gonna be a lifesaver for you. It's a complete game changer, okay? So before we actually get into the tutorial and I show you a little bit of a demonstration on how to use it, different websites that you can utilize it, and how I would basically approach it, Online Arbitrage Pro 3.0 is about to turn into Online Arbitrage Pro 4.0 with a number of other sourcing tutorials and other insights. I'm completely revamping the entire course. I'm super stoked about it. It should be live by the end of this week, roughly. I am also introducing a new pricing plan. So if you go over to Online Arbitrage Pro, a lot of people would say and they'd message me like, hey, I can't, you know, afford the actual course price anymore. So what I did is I introduced a bunch of different payment plans because obviously I give away coupon codes here and there, but some people would message me and be like, hey, I can't really afford the entirety of the price. Do you have a coupon code? And because I told other people that there was only a set amount of coupon codes, I couldn't just give them away to everybody at that current time because I'd already said that there was only X amount of coupon codes for that actual claim. So I hope that those people understand it, number one. But number two, I've actually introduced a number of other payment plans that you can actually hop into the course for, so it becomes a little bit more manageable, right? So for example, there is a 30-day free money-back guarantee, right? So if for whatever reason you're unhappy with the course, you could always get your money back within 30 days. So the payment plan allows a lot of other people to get into the program to test it out for super cheap. And if for whatever reason it's not for you, or you don't see success with any of the sourcing softwares or any of the business models, then by all means, just ask for a refund, cancel, it doesn't matter, okay? I'm very excited to launch 4.0. Remember, payment plans, first link in the description for Online Arbitrage 3.0 currently, but that will be 4.0 by the end of the week, okay? Enough of the promotions, let's hop into the tutorial. So if you go to oagenius.com, there's a number of different suppliers here that they'll list if you actually check into the actual software, okay? So if you scroll down, you'll see that it kind of scrolls through here and you can literally sort through all the lists, right? So like Walmart, Overstock, Home Depot. So you can't source every, one of the drawbacks of this is that you can't source every single bulk deal site, right? So you can't go to like Slick Deals, I don't know what that was, but you can't go to like slickdeals.net or like gamestop.net or .com, which are two of my favorite sourcing sites, and use the OA extension, it's not gonna work, right? It doesn't integrate with that actual site. But there are, you can actually utilize it on all the sites that it does integrate to. So if you go back to these, look, eBay, for example, right? great opportunity. Bed Bath & Beyond, another great opportunity. Walmart, Fleet & Farm. There's a number of sites here that you can source, and there's a number of products that you can source from. I'm specifically going to show you Walmart here today and how I would approach it with Walmart, but there is a number of product opportunities, a number of sites to source from, okay? Now, OhAGenius is actually a sourcing software. There's a bunch of other features here, but if you don't actually sign up for the trial, right, and you just go to the Google Chrome store and search for OhAGenius, you can download the extension for free and just simply use the extension. You don't have to actually pay for a payment plan. You don't have to actually go to the actual website and sign up for any of the inventory management or any of the product sourcing software. You can simply use the Chrome extension for free, okay? Now that we got that out of the way, let's hop over to Walmart. So what I would do with Walmart, let's say you're on like the homepage, right? So we'll go to walmart.com and you're like, okay, it integrates with Walmart. That's great. How do I source through Walmart with this software? Well, all you need to know is what OhAGenius is going to do is it's going to pull all the product pages or all the products currently on that page, and it's going to try to search for them in real time on Amazon to spit you out the data for a corresponding listing that looks very, very similar on Amazon, okay? So then it's going to save you a bunch of time because then you can literally look at the listing and see, okay, is this a profitable product? And if it's not, you don't even want to waste your time looking into it further. And if it is, you want to make sure that the product is the actual same exact corresponding product. I found similar products that are literally almost the same, but not exactly the same. So you do have to be careful here and there, but you'll see pretty easily if it's the same product picture. And then you can look a little bit more in depth. Is it the same exact product? Is it a bundle? Is it a variation and all that sorts of stuff, right? So if I would use the OhAGenius, I know that this is basic, this tutorial specifically right here, but I want to kind of get this out of the way so I can clarify for people. Obviously, you can't run the OhAGenius extension on like a site where there's no product information, because like while there's like main products here, there's no prices. So it's not going to work like that. So you need to go to an actual page that has product listings, their prices, and a lot more data, right? You want like product identifiers, like SKUs, you know, potential UPCs or something like that. So it can literally search Amazon for the title, the pictures, and the product identifiers, like the SKUs or the, not the ASIN, obviously, because that will be on Amazon, but like the UPC and stuff like that. So what I would do in this specific example is instead of actually going through and sourcing through all these little manual, categories myself and trying to find a good product identifier, and there are softwares that I'll cover in tutorials in the future, like SourceWave, for example, or Tactical Arbitrage. Not a huge Tactical Arbitrage guy, but I think like Source Mogul is a good one. There's a couple of different ones, but this one, if you don't want to pay for a software like that monthly, because a lot of people don't either want to pay for a software or don't want to learn a software like that or don't have the time to learn a software like that or don't want to actually, you know, spend the money every single month and have another expense, this is going to be a lifesaver for you. So what I would do is I'd go to like Saving Spotlight, which is basically the equivalent of like a clearance section or the sales section, right? And you could go to like Saving Spotlight Today or Pick Up Today to find product opportunities that you can go pick up in a local store. Or you could even go to like, electronics or video games, right? One of the ones that I like to go is video games because I feel like they sell super quickly. So here we are on the video game tab right here, just on the main homepage. And so if we sort down, you can obviously just see like there's three different pages that I want to scan here. So literally just on this page right here, I'm just going to click the OhAGenius integration right here, the Google Chrome app, and I'm going to drag it down so we can see a little bit more information. And what it's going to do is it's going to search for this product picture, this product title, and obviously pull in the relevant information for a listing that looks exactly like that on Amazon and tell me what the price is so I can literally go down and look. Okay, this is the source price, meaning this is what Walmart.com is charging me to buy it, so this is what I'm spending. This is the buy box price for the corresponding listing that it thinks is that exact product on Amazon. So if it does look good, you want to check it after the fact. And it's going to tell me the best seller rank as well in the right column. It's also going to be like the ASIN here, and you can click this, obviously, either one of these to actually go to that specific corresponding page. So there's no buy box information on this one, so I'm going to avoid it. Because this is, look, right here, here's a potential product opportunity right here, because you're buying this for $300, it's the reverse, because you're buying it for $300, and the buy box price is lower at $212, so not a good product opportunity. So let's scroll down a little bit more. So right here, this could be a product opportunity right here. You're paying $250 for this system, or this bundle, and it's selling on Amazon for $400 as the buy box price. So what we want to do is we want to actually go through and look to what this is. So on Walmart.com right here, This is Xbox One, one terabyte, I don't even know what that means, to be honest, Forza Horizon Lego Speed Champion Bundle. And it comes with a bonus headset and a month Game Pass. So we clicked this one to see what the Walmart listing was. Let's click the ASIN one to see what it is on Amazon. Is it the same actual thing? And it looks very similar, but we'd want to look into that. So that's one terabyte, Forza Horizon with Lego, Forza Horizon with Lego. Does it come with the extra headset as well? I'm not actually sure, but you could look into that. I wouldn't actually go out and source this product myself. I don't necessarily love the games and game systems like this. I know some people literally exclusively source them. I don't really like to take a risk into that. I'd rather risk, like, you know, wholesale with that because I know it's going to sell. I'd rather risk like books with that because I have more experience and I know those books are eventually going to sell during textbook season. So I don't necessarily like to put a lot of my risk into a product like this because God forbid it gets damaged in shipment to FBA. Or God forbid it gets damaged in shipment to, you know, the customer, right? I'm out $250 and I'm never going to see that. So I just personally don't like to take the risk in high, you know, more ROI products. If you like that and you have more money to throw into this business model, by all means, go after that. So let's find a better opportunity here. This one, obviously, you're sourcing less, but there's no profit margin to be made. This one is not. So you get the picture. I'm not going to waste a lot of your time, but this is just an opportunity here that's going to show you potential products that you can buy. So here's one right here. It's a little bit of a different one, $14.99, and the buy box price is $24.99. So obviously, if this were the same product, which it doesn't look like it is, and all this is doing is it's saving you time, right? Because it's literally outlining right here. I could go through this faster and look at them all and be like, this isn't profitable. Okay, next page. Let's scan it. Sort through all the products and be like, okay, this isn't, this looks like a good product opportunity. Let me look a little bit more into that. And that way you're only looking into like three or four potential products, you know, in a span of a bunch of listings, like hundreds of listings, instead of literally going to the corresponding listing each time and checking it, because you're going to waste a ridiculous amount of time doing that. Okay. So if this were the same, obviously, which it might not be, obviously this looks like it's a different color here. So it's like a wetlands camo one, and there's no variation with camo, so it's not the exact same, but let's pretend that it was. Obviously, this might be a good product opportunity, so if it were, then obviously I'd want to go through and check to see if it was profitable, if I could sell it, if it's selling well, what the competition on that listing looks like. Might want to check into the Keepa chart to make sure that the price hasn't like tanked recently or spiked recently and that's an anomaly. There's a number of different things. I've talked about so many of those things in other tutorials, so I'm not going to cover them here today. But obviously, if this were the same thing, this might be a good opportunity if I could sell it and if the competition on the listing was good and it looks like it's selling well because it's Amazon's choice. So if we click the Jungle Scout Chrome extension, it's telling us it's selling 82 daily sales. So that's a shitload. If we checked, we're going to source it for $14.99. We have free shipping on Walmart. We're gonna come in and say that the product cost is $14.99. Maybe it costs us a buck to ship it into FBA. We're gonna sell it for $24.99. So then the profit per unit actually isn't even really there because you're paying a lot in fees. So you're paying $8.60 roughly in fees. So it's still not a good product because you're only gonna make 41 cents. And I don't wanna spend $15.99 with shipping to make 41 cents. So that is an example of a bad product. And I'm not gonna waste your time and sort through all these. But if I didn't find anything on this first page, I would simply go to the next page and sort through the next page, right? Or maybe I go back to a different category and sort through another page in a different category. And this is a software that is not perfect, right? It's not going to scan the entirety of the websites automatically like a software like SourceMogul or like, you know, Tactical Arbitrage might, for example, but it is a great free integration that you can utilize today from your computer to save time when you're sourcing manually for online arbitrage. So I really hope you guys like this tutorial. I'm very excited about this software, but not just this software, a number of the other softwares I plan on creating tutorials on in the future. Remember, Online Arbitrage Pro 3.0 is gonna turn into 4.0 by the end of the week. There's a great opportunity to hop in now, learn all the content as it kind of changes, so you can get off and running quickly and really take advantage of all the new updates. I'm really excited about it. Hope you guys are. Give it a thumbs up if you appreciate the value in today's tutorial, and I'll see you in the next one.